You got to circumcise yourself. And he says, then Abraham, you need to circumcise your Ishmael. This almost confused me, because Ishmael means your problem. How am I going to circumcise my problem? Well, if circumcise means cut off, you already got it then. I'm going to cut off my problem. You only said nothing yet. Look at somebody good and say, neighbor. Y'all got to help me. Look at somebody and say, neighbor. I'm getting ready to circumcise my problem, to cut off my issues, to close the door on it. I'm not calling them no more. I'm not going around there no more. I'm not giving in no more. I'm not crying on the shoulders no more. I'm cutting off my problem. Somebody shout, yeah. Somebody shout, yeah. Come on, shout glory again. Well, after I circumcised myself, I still got to deal with the stuff I tore up. I got to deal with the illegitimacy that came out of me. I'm stuck with the Ishmael. I finally got my mind back. But now that I've cussed out the whole house, I got to go back to my own house and start ministering peace. I said peace in my own house. I can't preach peace out the house and have the devil in the house. And I'm too stubborn and sitting there to bow down to be humble therein. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, whatever the problem is, you got to cut it off. Whatever the problem is, you got to cut it off. You got to cut it off. You got to let it go. You can't keep carrying it into your 2013. You got to cut it off and let it go. The Bible says that not only did he mess with them and say, look now, he says, if you won't grab your promise, look at somebody and tell them, I know I got some promises.
I know I got some.
Look at them good and say, I know I got some stuff coming.
I know I got some stuff coming.
I heard the word of the Lord say, if you're going to hold to your promise, if you're going to hold on to your promise, then you're going to have to get into this place. You got to get in this place where you're willing to cut it off. Look what God told him. He said, look, don't be afraid to cut off your Ishmael. Don't be afraid to deal with your problems. Don't be afraid to send your problems down the road. Because if you let it go, look what I'll do. He said, I've already blessed Ishmael. I dare you to look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, if you let it go, if you get right and be delivered, if you let it go, if you straightened up and fly right, look at somebody and say, neighbor, if you turn it loose, if you find the law, then you shout, yeah, shout, yeah, shout, yeah. We're taking the E flat minor. Look at somebody good, that's what, get ready to go. Look at somebody and tell them, neighbor, neighbor, you've got to cut it out. If you can't cut it off, cut it out. If you can't leave them alone, leave them out. If you can't quit calling them, then stop calling at all. You've got to let it go. Shout, yeah! Shout, glory!
Right.
Ishmael had to be cut off. And I'm no longer gonna keep announcing my Ishmael. I'm no longer in 2013 gonna keep broadcasting my Ishmael. I'm gonna stop giving Ishmael all the praise and the glory.
Hallelujah.
I'm gonna get off Facebook and stop telling everybody about my Ishmael. I'm gonna get off the gossip line and stop telling everybody about my Ishmael. Because everybody don't understand that you're delivered from your Ishmael.
Right.
You ought to nudge somebody and tell them, neighbor. You ought to get them good with your elbow and say, changing. Woo! Self-esteem, I'm changing. Spirit of depression, I'm changing. Spirit of anger, I'm changing. The old time way, he said, if you'll cut it, I'll covenant it. If you'll cut it, I'll come into covenant with it. I heard my Holy Ghost say, if you'll release it, I'll reward it. Ain't got no help yet. If you get rid of the problem, I'll bring you in your promise. Let me try this again. I heard the Holy Ghost declare that if I get willing to cut it, he'll go in covenant with me. Look at somebody, tell them, neighbor, it might be tough, it might feel bad, it might get hard, but if you're willing to cut it, God will covenant it. God will come into agreement with his word, and his word will agree with your life. You want to shake somebody and tell them, neighbor, look at somebody and tell them, neighbor, I'm getting ready. For everybody that's looking at you funny, you ought to lean over and say, neighbor, I don't care what they think. They can kiss my past. Look at them again and say, neighbor, they can kiss my past. Good God. It's in the sea. In the sea of forgiveness. Never. Look at somebody and tell them, neighbor, get their attention and say, neighbor, you got to cut it out. Look at them good and say, neighbor, you got to get rid of it. Look at them good and say, neighbor, where the Lord is taking you. Into 2013 and start asking for my promises. Y'all got to understand that it's already ahead of me. That's why we're already trying to catch up, because it's already in front of us. It's already there waiting on us. The one condition is that when you come into your promise, you just can't come in being the same old way. You can't come in with the same old attitude. You can't come in with the same old emotions. You can't come in being the same old crybaby. You can't come in being the same old messy folk. You can't come in being the same old itching ears. You can't come in being the same old gossiper. You can't come in trying to learn anybody business. You can't come in with the same old, same old. But if you don't come in, you got to carry it on. You got to understand what 2013 is going to do. Because 2010 represented divine power. And when we were in 2010, you didn't even know it, but God was giving you divine power. And because you didn't know you had power, 2011 brought in revelation. Because you didn't understand what you had in the last year. So God gave you understanding in 2011. And now you got revelation in 2011. God brings you to 2012, which is authority.
Divine authority.
It's divine authority.
Yes, sir.
And now I hear God saying, look here, I can't give you power. I can't give you revelation. I can't give you authority without giving you a circumcision. Because every time you get power, you start drawing different folk to your life. Every time you get anointed, you get another demon to your life. Every time you get revelation, you get another spirit that want to be your buddy. I got no help yet. But I preach to all the folk who got some buddies in the year 2011, only to find out that they were the next year's devils. That you were all the stuff. To elevate you. Y'all don't see this yet. But the enemy began to dispatch demons after you. And these spirits ain't always coming in looking violent and ugly and crazy. Sometimes these spirits dress up just like you. And sometimes these spirits know more scripture than you.
Yes, they do. Yes, they do.
Sometimes these demons know more spirituality more than you. They can describe dreams. They can prophesy and preach. The Bible says they will fool the very elite and elect if it was possible. I just felt another anointing. Yeah, the Bible declared that these spirits would come in and attach themselves. The Bible said that the parable of the wheat and the tare, while a certain man was sleeping, there came a sower. The sower being Satan himself. And he sowed in seeds that looked like wheat. They smelled like wheat. They grew up like wheat. But their identity was demonic. Their identity was a tear. And anything that's tearing, that's severing apart. That's why the Lord didn't say that you got to tear it off. He said you got to cut it off. Y'all understand that? Because to tear it off is to invite a spirit of the enemy to come in like a tear that looks like a wheat. I have you wrong and thinking you're right. Ain't got no help yet. You ought to have on somebody and tell them, amen. I see that devil. I see him where he is. Every time the Lord begin to elevate you, here comes another spirit trying to befriend you. Every time the Lord tried to lift you up, here comes another a situation to pull you down. I don't know if you ever notice every time your prayer life gets good, here come another dilemma on your job. Every time you get your pastor back, here comes some foolishness in your family. They got no help yet. I say every time you get elevated, the enemy discharge another enemy against you. And I heard the Lord declare, I know you've been doing it for the last 12 years, but in the 13th year, I'm going to cut off everything that looked right, but it wasn't right. I'm going to cut off everything that looked like me, but it wasn't me. I'm going to cut off everything that exalted itself against the will of God. You ought to look at your neighbor and tell a neighbor, well, the Lord set me free. I'm trying to close, I promise. Give me a second. Give me a seat. What you don't understand is that sometimes God will downsize.
That's right.
Click my ride, die crew. You know what I'm saying? What's happening? We gonna go, what we gonna do this weekend? I got my click. I can always count on them.
Yeah.
Yes. Then out of the blue, God will start sending one of them away.
Why you didn't want to leave me when the Lord sent me?
That's just how it is, man.
Yeah. One of the clicks out the way. One of the clicks out the way now.
What's up with you? What's up with Deacon?
He tripping, that's, he always had the thing, you know what I'm saying, he tripping. He messed around, got him a car, now he taking good, all the brothers, you know what I'm saying? Yeah.